So the key to the story is, when you find that there's something you're not succeeding at, don't give up. Learn how to do it.
I'm Zachary Fowler.
And that's the Wooded Beardsman. And this is
season 4 of the Wilderness Living Challenge.
The goal of the challenge is to gain or maintain our body weight while eating nothing but wild foods. So last October, I headed up to the backwoods of Canada to meet up with the Wooded Beardsman and do just that for 7 days. Last time on Wilderness Living Challenge Season 4.
It's so loud and there's so much wind and so much rain. Holy cow. Just a couple more degrees.
And there'd have been no more Wooded Beardsmen.
That's 1-1. It's not a competition. Nope. mine's bigger.
Alright. So you want to clean a dirty pike, right?
So our eating wild part of the series is over technically, but we didn't want it to end just yet. So we head out on one last adventure to see if we can get ourselves a goose before I drive back to Maine.
Six 6:00 in the morning, early bird gets the worm. We're heading on over to Adams and we're gonna see if we can get that goose. Maybe a duck as well. Okay. We're all geared up.
Yep.
You ready? You got your nice...
Can you see me even?
No, I can't even see you. You disappear against the backdrop of urban, suburban, with that crazy camo.
Yeah.
Like ninja camo.
Ninja camo.
You are in luck. You see, my highest grades were in stealth. Let me give you an example.
Five. What would you like today? Good morning, what would you like today?
Large coffee, black.
Okay, $2, see the window.
You guys take American?
Today, yep. Is that
all you got?
Yep.
Thank you. Right, I had to do it American. What do they say?
I give them a 5 and all they give me is 2 quarters.
You didn't get 2 quarters.
They're 2 Canadians.
You gotta show them what they are though. You got a toonie and a loonie.
Yeah. A toonie and a loonie.
Yeah, $1 and $2.
They're like a piece of money stuck inside of another piece of money accidentally.
That's a toonie.
Yeah. We're here with Adam Craig Outdoors. Check out his YouTube channel below. He's taking us out on a goose hunt. And of course, the Wooded Beardsman. We're in like near North Bay here in northern Canada, Ontario. Whatever. And get it.
Somewhere like that.
Yeah, we're in Canada. It's far away from America. So we're gonna have some fun today. Stick around.
Get all the shots, man.
Get it all, what's happening. You don't miss anything.
Oh, I've got a piece of wood going.
He's got a wood. No, camera. You'd think we'd get sick of this.
Yeah.
You know, but it becomes like part of your life. My camera. Everywhere I go, it goes with me.
Wherever I go.
No, I get it.
He gets it.
Yeah. Sun's just starting to shine on the world over there. Look at the colors coming out of those maples over there. Beautiful. So as we're setting these out here, Adam was telling me that he went, what was it, last year you went with a buddy, and that's how you got the bug for goose hunting?
Yeah, we went and hunted some farmer's fields that we had permission to hunt, but we had no real setup, there was no decoys, no calls, and we were trying to shoot geese at like 75 feet in the air, or 75 yards, sorry, and that's way too far.
Yeah, and so it wasn't working. And what'd you do?
I came home and started researching and watching YouTube videos and everything I could think of. Went and got some decoy shells, turned them into floaters. And then I started having success once I learned how to do a couple calls.
So the key to the story is, when you find that there's something you're not succeeding at, don't give up. Learn how to do it. YouTube, books, find out, study, learn, and be successful at it. You don't have to always have somebody to hold your hand to do things. Get out there, learn how to do it, try the things, and succeed at it.
Awesome, buddy.
What you got there?
That's a jerk rig, they call it. You just use a piece of bungee cord on the one end anchored into the water. I just use a windshield washer jug.
Ha ha.
Oh, geese are coming, boys.
Another chance at more of them coming back. So close, they flew around twice and turned away and kept going. So first thing you need to know about your slingshot is which end to shoot with. No, basically it's really simple. You got your slingshot, you got your ammo, put your ammo in your pouch. And the most important thing about that is that you're pinching just the ammo. You don't want to pinch in front of the ammo so it jumps over your finger when you shoot. That looks like this. You're pinching just the ammo. You draw it down away from you, so if it ever elastic does snap, it snaps now, right, and not like and smacks you in the cheek. Down and away from you, and you're gonna sight down those bands right here and line up your target right on the end of the slingshot. So that's your line of sight, aiming down with your eye and lining it up on your target. And when you release, you just wanna let it slide free of your fingers, just lightly as possible. And maybe even put a little bit of back pressure on this hand here so it comes straight back. So keep that elbow up so it's straight in line with the bands. And release.
I spend a bit more time explaining this all to him right here, but I'm not going to waste your time with that. But if you do want to know more about how to shoot a slingshot, check out the How to Shoot a Slingshot page on my website or the How to Shoot a Slingshot playlist here on YouTube. Specifically, the How to Shoot a Slingshot video by Zachary Fowler is the most comprehensive How to Shoot a Slingshot video ever made.
Let's put this cup up over here on a stick, and then we'll be able to you can try it.
Sounds good.
Look good?
Yep.
Bring it back, draw it up, and then bring it up to the hairs your cheek are touching. And boom. Let me empty my ammo belt out into my pocket here. And we can use up the ammo in here. Wazoo survival belt, full survival kit in there, and I think that's about 25 pieces of ammo I had inside there. First try ever.
Does that look right?
Yeah, looking good.
Oh, low. Okay, so low. I dropped my hand. I felt I did that.
Oh, that was so close. Oh. Oh, so close.
You want me to shoot the cop? I'll shoot the cop. That's how you shoot a cop.
Well, coming to the end of our hunt, no success. I flew in, flew around. Might have had a chance where we could have shot on my side. I thought we were waiting for him to land. Novice at this. Maybe next year. Chris says he's coming back out tomorrow and see if he can't get something.
Turns out he did get something. He got himself a duck. His channel is linked below in the description and also at the end.
But otherwise, skunked. And I gotta head back to home, my little family. So this might be the end of it unless this clip never sees the light of day because magically something happens in the last 10 minutes here before we head out. All alone, again. Just gonna play that up for the rest of my life. If I never achieve anything else, I at least achieved 87 days alone in Patagonia. No. Well, I got skunked, no goose, close calls, but we didn't even get to fire some shots. So maybe next time I come to Canada, make sure you check out, what's your YouTube channel's name? Adam Craig. Make sure you check out Adam Craig Outdoors, who was nice enough to take us out here on his property for a goose hunt. And just so you don't feel completely disappointed, here's a beautiful goose right here. Canadian adventure is almost over. You can't stay here, but you don't have to go home, but I do. So we're unloading all of our stuff and separating our life. So it's been 8, 9, I don't know how many days now. I'm losing track of it.
10
days or something like that. And we're separating all our stuff back out and heading in our separate directions. Me to Maine and him to actually do some more hunting and adventuring. Oh, I almost took home a nice set of arrows I found in my gun case. There's even a fancy stone tipped one in here.
Ray Fletcher
made him this one. Cane. Hand fletched, beautiful arrow. Oh, he'd be some unhappy if he found that he had left that in my. Like, not the best looking slingshot, but I had a hard time finding a really good one. This will work great though, it will. wanted a keepsake. Memories.
We're losing track of days. We're just having so much fun being so busy.
Yes!
TMI for your audience, right? It was a squirrel.
And you jam it inside the duck. Determined to go fishing, and your ex-wife's car won't make it up into the bushes. I got two, and he's got no. I'm just kidding.
Oh. Backwards.
Yeah.
That's okay. Keep
what
going.
Did I say? Bearded woodsman.
Yeah, bearded woodsman. That's another guy.
Yeah. This'll do. The gift that I brought up with me is a backpack from the Hidden Woodsman. It's the Scout Pack. Nice little pack, bright orange in size, some zipper pouches.
Awesome.
And it's traditionally designed off of like World War II stuff, but with modern gear, so it's waterproof and pretty slick. He'll be
cool. That's like perfect for going brook trout fishing, man.
Yeah.
I can put my lunch in there, water, pot.
Your camera, your
worms, lunch, camera.
Boom. It's just enough for a little adventures away from camp and stuff usually.
Thanks, man. Thanks, Malcolm, the Hidden Woodsman. I'll give you a link too, because that's really cool, man. Thanks. Beauty.
Yeah.
Thanks, Huck. Okay, so.
We didn't exchange gifts when we first met, because we just like hit the ground running.
Hit
we're like,
the ground running.
Go.
Okay, so I gotta explain, I know Zach's keto, so these are not all for him. My wife put it together.
Is there anything in there for me?
I explained to him that he was keto, but it was more for your kids. Right?
That's
to have something Canadian.
Thoughtful wife. They always do something nice
she's
for
like,
the kids.
It was for the kids.
She, yeah.
You know, we're adults, we don't get presents. But you are gonna get a Grohmann hat and t-shirt. Grohmann's
nice.
A sponsor of mine.
Nice.
So and
you wear this a lot and I get a knife probably in the mail someday.
You might.
I see the future.
Give them a call. Grohmann's really nice.
I like been, that. That was been, a great knife.
They've been good to me. I always carry my Trout and Bird. Yeah, give them a message and let them know that you're affiliated with me and we hung out together.
It's all my favorite things in here.
I know. Maybe you have to cheat one time. Just
no,
one time.
I can't. But
so apparently Americans do not have these treats.
I can't even read what's on here. It's in the French.
Yeah, there's French, right? So ketchup chips. You guys have ketchup chips in America?
What's that say?
All dressed, assaisonné.
All dressed. I can read all dressed.
All dressed, ruffles. Okay?
I just because I a seasoning.
So all dressed chips, you guys don't have those, I don't think. Dill pickle chips, you guys have dill pickle chips?
Yeah, we have dill pickle.
Okay, so you have dill.
Only recently, I think.
Do you have hickory sticks?
No.
The hickory sticks? No? Yeah. No hickory sticks?
Okay. Yeah. Abby will love those.
These are
gummies.
Swedish gummies. There's not a lot of sugar in this, mostly gummy stuff.
My favorite gummies.
Maynard's gummies. Do you have those?
No. Yeah, we have gummies, not necessarily.
Yeah,
that
you probably brand. Don't have these.
Nope.
No, so maple leaf, maple flavored.
Oh.
Maple flavored cookies.
You can have I might have to save those for Vermont. And my mom loves
day,
maple
we've been
flavored.
Good. Kraft dinner, KD. You don't have this flavor, I don't think.
No.
And it's not called KD. So there's a KD.
It's a Canadian Kraft dinner.
It's Kraft dinner, yeah. Yeah.
Cool.
Okay. So for the kids.
The girls
right?
love Kraft
this,
dinner.
This I don't know. This is a mystery box. I think it's like chocolates.
Oh really?
Yeah. It's gonna be torture. All right. I'll have a look. What do we got? Yeah. We
oh.
Got different... No, I don't want to ruin it.
Yeah.
I don't know how my wife packed it in there, to be honest.
Yeah.
All right, so it was a good trip. Thanks for coming.
Yeah.
Come back anytime you want. Just let me know. Give me a few days in advance.
Yeah.
And we look forward to doing a future collaboration. Yeah, maybe go to Maine.
Or maybe eat some lobster?
Yeah, maybe just go someplace completely different.
We'll go lobster hunting.
Yeah, I'm going to catch you for the lobster.
All right, thanks, man, for having me. I learned a lot. Check out the Wooded Beardsman. Down below, the link is there. We got some seriously awesome adventures. Now I gotta head back to Maine.
Have a good drive. Yeah.
Next time on Wilderness Living Challenge Season 4. I filmed one more thing before I left. Got a nice long interview with the Wooded Beardsman, asking him all the hard questions you've been asking in the comments. We're gonna sit down and talk for a good 45 minutes, so tune in next time. Catch that last episode.
Oh, dude! You forgot the camera! You've got your camera.
Nice. All right, thank you.
Yeah. Take drive, man.
All right, peace.
Let me know when you get home.
Yeah. quick stop at Timothy Horton's, and a special thanks to Timothy Horton for making good coffee that tastes so much better than Dunkin' Donuts. I know that's not very American of me, but yuck, Dunkin' Donuts, gross.
$2.
Thank you.
No problem.
This car is a mess. All right, I plotted my route. And 10 hours.
Next left onto Pinewood Park Drive.
And 57 minutes.
This episode has been brought to you in part by Bath Subaru on Route 1 in Woolwich, Maine. They set me up with a beautiful orange Subaru Crosstrek 2013. I'm gonna mod it all out. She's gonna be the new Mischief Mobile, maybe not as modded out as this, but something in between so I can do some road miles and some adventuring in it, maybe a little bit of camper action on top. So if you're in the market for a bit of adventure, stop on by Bath Subaru, tell them Fowler sent you, links in the description below.
In 600 meters, turn left onto Vermont 114 North.
Woo! Oh man, just pulling into Vermont. Ah, oh, good to be back in America. Woohoo! They let me in. They said I can go home.
Daddy!
Oh, hi!
Daddy. Daddy, are you okay?
You got stuff to show me?
Yeah.
I didn't even really get a hug. You were like, I want to get down and show you stuff. Come here, give me a hug. It sucks. Back up. Give me a hug. Give me a hug. I missed you so much. Hey, where's Abby? She's already in there trying to watch TV, isn't she, the little goober? Are you wearing underwear?
Yeah.
They're wet. Yeah.
I missed you, Daddy.
I missed you too, honey. All right, should we open the treats?
Yeah.
All right.
Put them down.
Chris sent these treats for you guys. You got some chips.
Yeah.
Oh, you guys want the, all right, you guys want to see what's in the box?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. What's in the box? Sugar. Thank you, Chris. Tell your wife thank you for sending the treats. The girls loved them. You like them? They're Canadian gummies. Say thank you. Thank you, Wooded Beardsman.
Thank you, Wooded Beardsman.
Hopefully you watched it all and you enjoyed it and you weren't too disappointed. If not, sorry. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching anyway. Fowler out.